The second is innovation at the regulatory level. Now, I can give two examples. So on the one hand, for instance, when you look at what is the cheapest way to decarbonize the universe, one of the cheapest ways is energy efficiency. But on the other hand, when you look at buildings, energy costs are very very low in their mind frame, because they are more concerned with the cost of the real estate, and they are indeed, even if you look at building operators or building owners, they are a lot more concerned at the productivity of the businesses that occupy that real estate. So energy, on the one hand, gets relegated to an afterthought when you look at buildings. However, on the other hand, energy is energy efficiency is one of the easiest wins for decarbonization at a global level. So there is some kind of a cognitive dissonance over here, and that's where regulations should step in. That's where there is some kind of an opportunity to make for business owners and operators to make decisions that are sensible, not just for themselves, but also sensible from a planetary perspective. If you look at some other examples of regulation, now in the past, we have seen lots of initiative from different governments in green certificate mechanisms and feed-in tariffs, all the support given by different subsidies to renewables, and that has undoubtedly helped them grow. Now, thankfully, we don't need those subsidies anymore. However, what we are seeing is a theme of convergence between different sectors. You see, energy and mobility converge because of the advent of electric mobility. You see buildings being not only a sink of energy, not only being a source of energy demand, but also being a source of energy supply, because you can have solar cells on the roof. So now, increasingly, the world of energy and buildings is also getting meshed up, and so on and so forth. So as you see, different sectors, maybe energy, mobility, buildings, real estate, lighting, all of these sectors are gradually converging with each other. And the convergence is led by the whole process of digitalization, because we are using data from each of these verticals to make sensible decisions on how to manage our energy needs. And that's where now, as a regulator, I need to start thinking differently. Right now, I've got a Ministry of Transport and a Ministry of Energy and a Ministry of Buildings and Real Estate and Property and so on. So you've got all of these siloed ways of regulating different sectors. And now actually need to start thinking more transversally. And because the telecoms that you thought of, which was only required to call up people or to download videos, is now going to be integral to really the way we manage our energy needs and the way we propel our planet towards more responsible uses of energy. So that's where you need more innovation on the regulatory side on how do I exploit, how do I manage the convergence of these different sectors. And last but not least, you need innovation at the commercial level. Now, I spoke about the convergence of these sectors. Well, somewhere there is a business model in there that exploits this convergence. So if I'm a company, I can't afford to call myself an energy company without understanding what mobility looks like in the future. I can't afford to call myself an energy company without understanding the use cases in buildings. And that's where I see room for integrated solutions, which combine a systems integration angle over and above the competences in each of these verticals, in each of these sectors. And that's what I've been engaged in. So I think that's where, so you see at a global level, which are the main drivers? The drivers are decarbonization, the drivers may be decentralization of energy, and of course, digitalization. There are various companies, including my former employer, with sink pains to these drivers. But this is how we bring these drivers together, to bring them together, to help them translate into a meaningful shift in the world. We need to look at innovation at the technological level, at the regulatory level, and at the business model. Sorry, that was a rather long-winded answer. I do apologize for that, but yeah, I'll just pass it to you.